Hello, and welcome to the video of the use of Excel-based rule engine. My name is George, and I'm from AlchemyJ. In this video, I'm going to show you an Excel-based rule engine and how to use it in your applications. This rule engine is powerful but simple and easy to use. It is a good alternative to other rule engines, such as Truth. Now, let's take a look at the agenda of this video. We start from an overview of this Excel-based rule engine. Then we shall download and set up the rule engine in your workstation. After that, we shall see how to define the rules and run the rules in Excel. Finally, I shall show you how to integrate the rule engine with your applications. Before we continue, please subscribe our YouTube channel at alchemyj.io/YouTube. Click the subscribe buttons and the bell so you will be notified for any new video from AlchemyJ. Let's have an overview of the Excel-based rule engine. First of all, it is completely free. You can download it and use it for free. And it is open source. You can view all the source code. The most powerful function of the rule engine is that it can run in various modes. You can run it in Excel, or you can run it as a batch process that interfaces with input and output files. You can also generate a REST API or Java package from this Excel-based rule engine, so you can integrate the rules with any applications. This rule engine requires absolutely no programming experience. All we need is simple Excel formula. If you are a complete beginner, I shall be here for your every single step. The rule engine provides a flexible model so you could easily customize it for your business requirements. You can also interactively change the rules and input values to check the result. That makes you easily validate your rules and fine-tune them with no effort. Let's see how to set up the rule engine. To set up the rule engine, you only need three steps. The first step is to download the rule engine from alchemyj.io. The second step is to copy the download file to your working directory. You can define any working directory you prefer, and there's no restriction to the working directory. Finally, you need to unzip the download file to get the rule engine. Let's see how to download the rule engine. You can browse alchemyj.io, which is the official website of AlchemyJ. Click the rule engine menu to open the page of the rule engine. Scroll down to the download button and click it. You can see the file is being downloaded to the default download directory of your browser. By the time of this video was created, the version of the rule engine is 1.4 and the download file name is simple-rule-engine_v1.4.zip. You may see other versions as new versions are coming out regularly. Then you can create your own working directory. In this video, we create working directory rule engine training under the root directory of C drive. But you can take any other working directory you prefer. Now you can copy the rule engine you just downloaded to our working directory, that is C:/rule-engine-training. Finally, you can unzip the file. Now you have the Excel-based rule engine installed. It is pretty simple, isn't it? Let's talk about how to start a new project of the rule engine. There are two types of projects you can create from the rule engine. The first type is to use simple rule engine with AlchemyJ. If you want to generate REST API or Java package from the rule engine, you should use the first type. The second type is to use the simple rule engine without AlchemyJ. If you just want to use the rule engine in Excel, you can use the second type, in which you have lesser parameters to define. To make our first project to be simple, we shall start a new project without AlchemyJ. If you open the directory of the rule engine, you can see there are two subdirectories. They are for projects with or without the integration with AlchemyJ. Each of these subdirectories contain another two subdirectories. They are for the sample and template. So in our case, we shall open the directory simple rule engine without AlchemyJ, then open the directory template. Then you can see there is a file simple-rule-engine-template.xrsm. This is the file you will use to start your new project. All you need to do is to copy the file to a new file for your project. In this case, we name our project to be rule-engine_demo.xrsm. So we make a copy of simple-rule-engine-template.xrsm and name it as rule-engine_demo.xrsm. If you open the file rule-engine_demo.xrsm, you can see these worksheets. In the Excel-based rule engine, we have a color convention. Cells in blue are supposed to be used by users. Cells in gray are not supposed to be used by users. They contain the formulas of the rule engine. And this color convention is applied across all sheets in the rule engine. Before we start to talk about how to define the rules, we first talk about the structure of the rules. Each rule in the rule engine contains two parts. The first part is the condition part, and the second part is the action part. This is just like the if-then statement. When the if condition is true, the rule engine will trigger the corresponding action. Here is an example. The condition is, if today is Sunday, the action is print Sunday. The complete rule could be interpreted as, if today is Sunday, then print Sunday. All the rules in the rule engine are in this format. Now, let's take a use case to illustrate the rule definition. This use case has two rules. The condition part of the first rule is, if the input value is a multiple of 4, and the corresponding action part is, print the input is multiple of 4. The condition part of the second rule is, if the input value is a multiple of 7, and the corresponding action part is, print the input is the multiple of 7. Now you may wonder how the rule engine takes the input from users. We shall talk about this later. For now, let's assume the rule engine can get the input from users by some means. Here are some scenarios. If the input value is 8, as 8 is a multiple of 4 but not a multiple of 7, so the rule number 1 will be fired, and input value is a multiple of 4 is returned. If the input value is 14, as 14 is a multiple of 7 but not a multiple of 4, so rule number 2 is fired, and the input value is multiple of 7 is returned. If the input value is 28, both rule number 1 and 2 will be fired, as 28 is a multiple of both 4 and 7. Hence, the input value is a multiple of 4 and the input value is a multiple of 7 will be returned. Now, let's start to define the rules for the rule engine. To define the rules for the rule engine, we only need 3 steps. The first step is to define the input cell. The second step is to define the rule condition. The third step is to define the rule action. Let's open the rule engine workbook, ruleengine_demo.xlsm. This is the workbook we have just created. To complete step 1, we need to open the worksheet named inout. Let's quickly refresh our mind in the color convention. Cells in blue are supposed to be used by users. Cells in gray are not supposed to be used by users, because they contain the formulas of the rule engine. The range of C4 to D35 is used to define the input data item. The rule engine will take data item in this range and run the rules. Each data item contains 2 parts, the name of the data items and the value of the data item. The name of the data item is defined in the range of C6 to C35. The value of the corresponding data item is defined in the range of D6 to D35. In our case, we have only 1 input data item, so we could define its name in C6 and its value in D6. Let's assign the data item name to be input, so C6 is input, and the value of the data item name input is contained in the D6. D6 could be any value you want the rule engine to process. To let us easily refer to the data item value, that is D6, we give a cell D6 a range name of input_value. Now we have finished step 1 of defining input cells. Let's move on to define the rules. Just to refresh our mind that every rule has 2 parts, the condition part and the action part. Let's start from the condition part. To define the condition part, we need to open the worksheet named rules. To keep our first exercise to be simple, most of the columns are not going to be used, so we only fill in the minimal information for rule number 1 and 2. We shall dive into the details of the other columns later. For each rule, we need to specify the rule group. The rule group is used for the classification of the rules. It is also used to run the rules dynamically. I shall show this to you later. Now, let's assign general as the rule group of the rule number 1 and 2. For the rule name, we shall use #1 and #2. Now we define the logic to fire the rules. To define the logic, you can use any formula in Excel. When the return of the formula is true, the rule will be fired. So we want to define the formula such that it will return true if the input value is a multiple of 4 or 7. We could use the function mod, M-O-D. Mod is used to find the remainder of a division. Mod takes two input numbers. It returns the remainder of the division of the number 1 divided by number 2. Usually, we can call number 1 as a dividend and number 2 is a divisor. Here are some examples of mocks. Based on the example, we can see that if number 1 is a multiple of number 2, then the remainder is 0, otherwise it is non-zero value. And it is the property of the function mock. So we can use mock to determine if the input number is a multiple of 4 or 7. In our case, we put mock open parenthesis input underscore value comma 4 close parenthesis equal to 0 in the cell J4. If you still remember, the input underscore value is referring to the cell D4 in the worksheet named in AL. So the formula determines if the input value is a multiple of 4. For rule number 2, the evaluation logic is the same, except that we replace the divisor by 7. Before we move on, we need to check the rule ID of each defined rule, as we shall use the rule ID later. Here you see the rule ID for rule number 1 is 1 and rule number 2 is 2. Let's define the action part of the rules. To define the action, we need to open the worksheet named action. First of all, we associate the action part with the rule part. The action and condition are linked by the rule ID. We need to put the rule ID of the corresponding rules of the action. In our case, the rule ID for the first action is 1, and the rule ID for the second action is 2. For each action, we could give a name to it. The name is contained in the column action. We give the same name to these two actions, and the name is return result. The column action output is the text to be returned by the action. We put the input value is a multiple of 4 for the first action. For the second action, we put the input value is a multiple of 7. The column of trigger condition allows you to define the formula to control if the corresponding action could be taken. I shall show you more example later. In our case, we want the action to be triggered all the time, so we put true for both action. Now we have complete the rule definition and we can run the rules in Excel. To run the rules in Excel, we need to switch back to the worksheet name in AL. If we put value 16 in D6, that is the input value, and press F9 to recalculate the workbook, you will find there's no output in the result tables. The reason is that we haven't specified the rule groups that are going to be run. You can specify the name of the rule groups to be run in a range of activated rule groups, that is the range of A6 to A35. So we put general in A6. That means we ask the engine to run all rules under the rule group general. Now we press F9 again. You can see outputs are displayed in the result table. The result table contains two subtables. They are the table of fired rules and the table of triggered actions. When the input value is 16, the rule number 1 will be fired, as 16 is a multiple of 4 and not a multiple of 7. In the triggered action table, you can see the text of input value is a multiple of 4. Now we can try different inputs. If we give the input value of 21, the rule number 2 will be fired, as 21 is a multiple of 7 and not multiple of 4. You can see the text of the input value is a multiple of 7 returned. If we give the input value of 56, both rule number 1 and 2 are fired, and the input value is a multiple of 4 and the input value is a multiple of 7 are returned. You can get this Excel demo file from the website alchemyj.io, so please check the website and download the file. Okay, let's briefly recap how does the rule engine work. The rule engine will take your input value, for example 16, Then it will run all the rules under the rule groups you specified, and it will return the action output in the result tables. But this is not good enough, as it only works in Excel, and we have to use the rule engine manually. The rule engine is supposed to be integrated with other applications. To integrate Excel-based rule engine with your applications, you can run it in three other different modes. The first one is a batch mode. You can save all input values of the rule engine in CSV files, that is, common separated files, then run the macro of the rule engine. Then the rule engine will take the input from the CSV files and run the rules, and save the output in the output CSV files. The batch mode enables the rule engine process a collection of input values in a single batch. It is suitable for batch processing such as day-end job. It could also be used with other automation tools such as RPA tools, that is robotic process automation. Okay, now we can integrate the rule engine with your applications. But it is still not good enough. The integration is a non-real-time basis. What we really need is a real-time based integration, so that your application can call your rule engines anytime to get the result immediately. The rule engine supports REST API mode. You can compile your rules and actions into a REST API. This is a very good approach, as the portability of the REST API is extremely high. Any applications that support the outbound call to REST API can integrate with the rule engine. However, the performance of the REST API integration is not good enough, as the overhead in network communication is high. To maximize the performance, we can run the rule engine in Java package mode. We can compile the rules and actions into Java package, so that any Java applications can have a native integration with the rule engine, and the performance of the rule engine could be maximized. In the coming video, I shall show you each of the running mode. Thank you for watching. Before you leave, please remember to subscribe our channel at alchemyj.io/YouTube and click the bell so you will be notified for any new video of AlchemyJ. Thank you.